Hello. I know it's about 1 a.m. here on the East Coast. I'm working on my book and on sermons. And if you're up, I'm sure you are on the West Coast around the world, why don't you text about five people or just call them and say, hey, wake up, let's do Bible study together. I was just thinking about people tonight and praying for you because that's what I do. I lay my hands on the prayer requests. I actually spent great time with the Lord today, 6 hours in worship and prayer and just spending time with God. And wanted to share with you, you know, the Bible says that as a man's soul prospers, so does his life. It also says, as he thinketh, so is he. So the actual translation for that is that as you thinketh, as one has thought all along, so it shall be. It tells us a lot about the way we think. Of course, Romans chapter 12, verse 1 and 2, to be not conformed to this world, but transformed by the renewing of our mind. And that's so important because renewing doesn't just mean, it means renovation, to take out the old and to put in the new. So we have to learn how to not just train our mind as far as a cognitive behavior, but to really ask God, help me overcome negative thoughts, negative thinking. As we're going into the new year, one of the things that I was doing today is I just literally spent 6 to 8 hours in worship and in His Word and asking God and saying, what is your will for my life? Because John chapter 7 says basically that we have our own will, God has His will, and the will of man, we know, will fail, but the will of God will prevail. And it says, what is the will of man to the will of God? And Jesus goes on and He says, I only do that which my Father has told me. I only do the will of God. So as I was thinking about it, I wanted to help you as you enter into the new year, how to kind of set that mind straight. And then I wanted us to pray together. Then I thought, maybe there are people going through some difficult times. Many of you know I lost my mother a week ago today. And God has given me an extreme sustaining grace and His peace. And I know she's in heaven. And but nevertheless, there's those moments of just, I miss her. And that part is always the difficult part. And I thought about what you might be going through. Is your heart heavy? Are you concerned about your children? What is the things that are burdening you down? Is there debt overload? Is there things that you seem to just having those repetitive cycles? Well, I believe in the power of prayer. Tonight, we stayed at church and we prayed for people to almost 10:30 tonight. I mean, we finished Brad preach. We finished Bible study pretty early, but we literally prayed over every person in the building because I believe 2019 is going to be a strong year for you, that you're going to see God's mighty hand move in your life, that it'll be a year of restoration, a year of recovering all, a year of advancement. And so I want to just give you 8 patterns according to the Word of God, 8 positive thought patterns. So Philippians is something you're very familiar with. Let's get into the Word of God. Got my big old Bible here. Love this Bible. I always go back to my favorite Bible. So as we look and we go over to Philippians 4:8, something that's very, very familiar. Can you hear me, guys? Yep. I think so. Thank you. Love you guys. Amen. Paula, please save me. We're gonna all come together and pray. But here's 8 things I want to give you that this fast. Philippians 4:8. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue and if there be any praise, then think on these things. As you get ready to enter into 2019, by the way, if you're anywhere near Florida, be at our New Year's Eve service, I'm going to be preaching, John's going to be singing. We've got the Russian ballet coming. It's going to be epic. We've got all kinds of stuff. It's at New Destin Christian Center, and that is going to be New Year's Eve. We do prayer from 7 to 9, and then the service starts at 9, and we usher in the new year because I believe that word is so important and so vital to set the course for the year. So it says, think on these things. Number 1, 8 thought patterns. Whatsoever is true. Turn your phone. Oh, is it wrong, guys? Is my phone, is that better? There you go. Does that help? Somebody's saying turn your phone. So I hope that I just turned it right. So whatsoever is true. True means not concealed. Do not think on things that are hid, things that you're ignorant of. Don't let your mind play those like tricks on you or things that are hid or, you know, just things that you're ignorant, which means uneducated or unlearned of. New Destiny's in Apopka, Florida, by the way. We're right outside of Orlando. True means loyal and in accordance with reality. So thanks. Got my phone right. It's almost 1 a.m. in the morning. So think on these things, whatsoever's true. Philippians 4:8. Second, think on whatsoever things are honest. Honest means honorable, free from fraud or deception, marked by integrity. So what he's saying, think on the things that are free from fraud, that are free from deception. Think on whatever's just, means that which is equitable, that which is right by principle, because principles are non-negotiables. You have preferences, you have principles. Like if you're in your car, and I always say your GPS is your navigation, and it puts in the destination where you're going, and it'll tell you how to get there, what to do, etc. But then it doesn't tell you the preferences, like turn on your air conditioner, roll down your window, or turn up your stereo, or turn it down. It just tells you take a right in 1.3 miles. It gets you to your destination. So that's vitally important. Think on whatever is pure, what's clean, what's innocent, what's modest. And that's part of our walk with the Lord, to believe the best, to hope the best, to see the best in all people. Think on whatsoever is lovely, which means friendly towards the person that you're attached to in life, that brings the best out on you. Instead of thinking like, oh man, something must be up there. Think on all the good things. Think on all the great memories you have. You know, I'm saying this because I've been studying a lot, and instead of asking, like we said, thank you so much, we're going to pray over each other, like, why did my mom pass in Christmas, or why did this, or why? I think on all the great things. She didn't suffer. She's in heaven with Jesus. I think on all the wonderful memories, the moments we laughed together, the times I talked, how funny and feisty she was, how free she was. Just think on these things, whatsoever's lovely, whatsoever's friendly towards. Think on this, whatever is a good report, reputable, well spoken of. In other words, not the rumors, not the gossip, not the naysayers, not the negative, not the stuff that's just bombarding all the time. And then it says virtue. Think on these. Think what's virtuous, which means valor or intrinsic excellence, something that provides strength, the kind of strength that gives a lift. So I want you to think. And when you're saying this, like right now, I want you to imagine what provides strength for you. For me, it's getting in God's word. It's worship. It's being around my family. It's being with people that I love. Think on these things. Whatsoever is praise, and it's a commendable thing, a story that brings God praise. So I want us to pray together, because I want you to think on these things. Hello, Alaska, receive restoration. We're going to pray together. Pamela, happy new year. So good to hear from everyone. Nikki, amen. Ravinder, good morning. Yeah, it is morning, isn't it? And so Paige, family, I don't have singing, writing, music, singing, dancing. Paul, what does God say about suicide if they were born again? My daughter keeps asking. Boy, Jessica, that's a really deep, deep subject. I actually teach on that. If you go to Paula White Ministry, www.paulawhite.org, I think my teaching is on there. And maybe I'll do a Facebook Live about that, because there is a lot of thoughts about and a lot of the word pretty much answers almost all aspects of life, almost everything. And as many of you know, my father took his life when I was 5 years old. So I teach from A to Z if it's in the word. If God's silent about it, then I'm silent about it. But if the word of God says something, then I'm going to say something. Hello, South Africa. So how do we renew our mind? That's what I want to pray, that old thoughts that are holding you down, any burden that is not a God burden, any satanic burden that has been placed upon you would be lifted off you in the name of Jesus. So let's just enter in. Father, we come to you in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we just lift up everyone right now, that their needs, their hearts, whatever's heavy on them, that they would learn how to cast their cares upon you. We pray for Kelly for healing right now. We pray for everyone that is watching right now and those that will watch, as we are a tribe and a community that pray together. And tonight specifically, we're praying that our mind would be renewed, that we wouldn't take old thinking into a new year. As we enter into 2019, we believe you, God, for the renewing of our mind. So in the name of Jesus, I thank you that I shall prosper and be in good health, even as my soul prospers, that I do have the mind of Christ. I have the mind of the Messiah and do hold the thoughts, the feelings, and purposes of his heart according to Philippians chapter 2, verse 5. I lean not on my own understanding, but in all my ways I acknowledge you, Lord. You and you alone shall direct my paths, for my footsteps are being ordered by you. Today I submit myself and surrender to your word, knowing that your word, God, Isaiah 55, verse 11 says, your word shall not return void. So I thank you that your word will expose and sift and analyze and judge the very thoughts and purposes of my heart, the way I think about things, the way I feel about things. For the weapons of my warfare are not carnal, but they're mighty to the pulling down of strongholds. I refute arguments and theories and reasonings and every proud and lofty thing that sets itself against the true knowledge of God. I lead every thought and purpose away, captive into obedience of Christ the Messiah, the Anointed One. Today, I will be transformed by the renewing of my mind, that I may prove what is the good and acceptable and perfect will of God, which is your word. Your word is your will. So I surrender and submit myself to your word. Lord, your word shall not depart out of my mouth, but I shall meditate upon it day and night, that I may observe and do according to all that is written. For then, according to Joshua 1:8, I will make my way prosperous and I will have good success. I declare this over you. I decree this over you. And according to Job 22, verse 28, it will be established. My thoughts are the thoughts of the diligent, which tend only to plenteous. Therefore, I'm not anxious about anything. I cast all my cares upon you, Lord, every worry, every anxiety, in everything with prayer and thanksgiving, which means grateful language. I present my request to you according to Philippians 4, 6, and 7. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, shall keep my heart and mind through Christ Jesus. Isaiah 26, verse 1 through 3. Declares, in that day shall this song be sung in the land of Judah. We have a strong city, salvation will God appoint for walls and bulwarks. Open ye the gates, that the righteous nation, which keepeth the truth, may enter in. Thou wilt keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee, because he trusteth in thee. Perfect peace is interesting because it literally means peace, peace. It means to be safe, to be well, to be happy. And that's important. So as I fix my mind upon you, Lord, today, whatever's true, whatever's worthy of reverence, whatever's honorable and seemly, whatever's just, whatever's pure, whatever's lovely, whatever's lovable, whatever's kind, whatever's gracious, if there be any virtue, any excellence, if there's anything worthy of praise, I will think on these things. I will weigh on them. I'll take them into account. Today, I roll my works upon you. Lord, I commit and trust them to you wholly. You will cause my thoughts to become agreeable to your will. So shall my plans be established, and they shall succeed. In the name of Jesus, I pray this. Again, there's so many scriptures to give you, but let's come in agreement right now, because that's what I just wanted to share. To get your mind in right thinking. We know attitude determines altitude. And praisers get raised, complainers remain. So restoration, Barry, amen, hallelujah. Jenny, I received the word, your mind is fixed on the Lord. Praise God, DD, glory. Amen. God bless you guys. Pastor Paula is still alive. Pamela, praise God. The fact that we have breath in our body, the fact that God is still on the throne, he gives us a new day to fight forward. Pray for me that I'll be able to finish my book here, that there will be no more distractions. And of course, pray for my family as we go through the process of my mom's burial and everything that goes along with that. I love you guys. I'm praying for you. And God is good all the time. I so believe that. KKS, Betty, amen. Tiffany, I'm in agreement in Jesus' name. You know, the Bible says, even in Romans 8:28, that what the enemy meant for bad, God will turn it around for the good for those who love him, who are called according to his purpose. God bless you guys. Talk to you again real soon. Remember to go back.